Hey everyone, welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10. I'm your host, Che Dorena. A picture is supposed to capture your soul, encase all the beauty of the masterpiece that is you, like all the beauty in this picture. Me with a mustache, drunk on New Year's Eve. The allure of my glazed over eyes is enough to make a seasoned photographer stop and take a moment to appreciate it. Well, along with my drunken mug, we have a bunch of other cursed images on today's list of top 10 mysterious cursed photos ever taken. One of them is going to be Beethoven's nudes. I'm just kidding, if I had a picture of Beethoven's nudes, I would have sold them on eBay a long time ago. If you haven't already, I would love it if you guys would like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. And if anyone at home is craving more Most Amazing Top 10 content, you should go check us out on Instagram and Facebook. It's a great way to get to know myself and the other hosts just a little bit better. And without taking any longer, let's get into this list. At number 10, we have anti-freckle treatment. I think freckles are cute as hell. When a lady's walking around looking all sun-kissed, I'm like, God, she's so damn adorable. No one should ever try to get rid of their freckles. But back in the 1930s, people had different tastes and went to great lengths to feel pretty. So we ended up with people doing stuff like this. This looks so creepy. If you didn't know this was real, you would think it was pulled out of some Guillermo del Toro movie. It looks like what aliens hook you up to before they stick a tube in your brain. The covers on the eyes, ears, and mouth are supposed to protect your orifices from the dry ice that's applied to the skin. The idea is applying a small amount of dry ice to the face that burns off the top layer of skin, thus removing the freckles. Beauty is pain. But what happened is, as soon as the skin healed and then is exposed to sunlight, the freckles will return. Probably why this trend didn't catch on. At number 9, we have George Metesky's mugshot. Usually, if you just got locked up for a long string of crimes, you wouldn't smile with this "hi mom" look on your face. Unless you're extremely proud of your crimes. George Metesky didn't care who hated him after he was caught for planting pipe bombs in public places. Something he got away with for 17 years. Between the years of 1940 and 1957, he set up 33 pipe bombs to just murder random people. Like, dude, please get a better hobby. You're really making it hard for all of us to have a good time. Out of the 33 pipe bombs, actually only 22 went off, which led to a handful of injuries but no deaths. After he was caught, he told the paper that he was glad he did it. I guess he just wanted to be noticed. But there are more effective, less dangerous ways to get people to pay attention to you. Just get an Instagram account and then post pictures of your butt. Duh. At number 8, we have the Cape Scott time traveler. If I had a time machine, there would be a lot of things I would do. I would want to go back to see Mike Tyson win the heavyweight championship, take a sip of clean water before we started polluting it. But I don't think any things I would do would be sit on top of a pile of dirt with a bunch of workers. In the book Cape Scott, there's a photo that was taken in the year 1917. It's a bunch of old-timey people sitting on a giant pile of dirt, like I said. They're all wearing these old, boring clothes, except for one dude. One dude looks like his name is Dylan, and he just longboarded through a Terminator time portal. This dude has scraggly blonde hair, a t-shirt on, and shorts. I wouldn't be surprised if this dude fell through a time portal and his first words were, "Sick, I just shredded through time." I couldn't imagine a less useful person to get blasted into the past. He would forget to warn everyone about the Nazis, but everybody in the town would know how to kickflip. At number 7, we have the Black Knight satellite. If you love alien conspiracy theories, I have a good one for you today. This strange oblong object got its name because it somewhat resembles the Batman symbol. The photo was taken by NASA and given out to the public in the year 1989. The logical explanation for this mysterious device is it's a thermal blanket that was lost in space and now is stuck orbiting around the Earth. But the alien buffs on the internet are convinced that this is an alien satellite that has been spying on the Earth for 13,000 years. Where they got that number from, I have no idea. You know that crazy people on the internet have access to all the hidden files that we couldn't dream of getting a hold of. Conspiracy theorists speculate that the satellite has been the cause of every form of radio interference that we've ever experienced, dating back to the early tests that Nikola Tesla did. I personally have no idea, and I don't care if aliens are watching us. I mean, we should all be a little happier knowing that something out there is taking interest in our lives. At number 6, we have frozen Russian soldier. War is brutal. control, and you really need to do whatever you can to get your edge on the enemy, even if it's using dead bodies to scare the hell out of people. In 1939, the Finnish defenders would take the dead bodies of Russian soldiers that were frozen solid and then set them up for their enemies to see, giving the not so subtle reminder that we will kill you and then use your frozen corpse as scenic decoration. I mean, that would definitely work on me, remembering that there's not only a massive chance of dying, but that I would be dying cold. I mean, if I'm going to get shot and bleed out, at least let it be on a tropical beach where I have a mojito in one hand and then an empanada in the other. At my funeral, they could say he died doing what he loved, being drunk and eating. At number 5, we have pig passenger. My god, dude, it's fine if you want to have a pig roast, but you don't need to scare every child you pass on the way home. Like, put a tarp over that thing, dude. Its eyes are open. Could you imagine seeing this thing first thing in the morning? Like, good morning, I'm the nightmare pig. I'll give you 10 years bad luck and hip dysplasia. Listen, I know it's very hypocritical because I eat meat and I don't want to look at the horrific dead stare of the meat after it's been killed. But let me be a baby and enjoy my meat faceless, separated from my conscience. At number 4, we have a ballsy choice. It's very rare that you get to see the moment that a child's trauma is formed, but luckily we have this one. Honestly, this makes me laugh so goddamn hard. Seeing the fear in the child's face really brings a smile to mind. Oh, and if you're wondering what's slung over that kid's neck, it's 100% some animal's testicles. I don't know what kind, basing on the size, I'm gonna say maybe a bull's, or it could even be a camel's. I'm not sure which is worse. I'm sure they're both heavier than you would have guessed, and they have a great smell. At number 3, we have fun for one. Sometimes you think no one's looking, but just remember that you never know who's around. This kid thought he could get away with some public displays of affection, but it looks like someone caught him slipping. Like they say, don't knock it till you try it. I've never had my nipple sucked by a vacuum cleaner, but maybe it feels better than eating a sundae while having an orgasm. Even if it feels that good, I still think this kid should have waited until he was alone before he suction cupped one of his own man titties. You can tell by the unimpressed look on the photographer's face that he would rather be in a fish packing factory than in close proximity with this kid while he has his sexual awakening. The mystery in this photo is definitely why this kid thought this was okay to do while strangers were hanging out around him. Looks like they're in some sort of office, so maybe he was just bored? Like the kind of bored you get when you vacuum your own boobies? And also, this image is cursed because you are never going to forget it. At number 2, we have the White Lady of Worstead Church. It's photos like these that make me wonder if ghosts are real and what are they doing in their spare time. If we ever learn to talk to ghosts, they're gonna have so much tea to spill. They'll be like, girl, I've been dead for 2,000 years and you have no idea what I've seen. If you're a believer in the supernatural, then this picture is definitely gonna make your hair stand on edge. Peter and Diane Bertallo went to visit the Worstead Church, and Peter wanted to snap a nice picture of his lady while she was praying. And it looks like someone decided to photobomb. You can see the spectral image of what is thought to be an 1800s healer. She just wanted to pop in and be like, it's your girl, White Lady of Worstead Church, follow me on Instagram. And for the number 1 spot, we have something that made me gag just from looking at it. I guess we call this one Fat Gas Mask, or Gunt from Hell, or Fupa from No Return. This picture grosses me out to no end. This is one of the most cursed things I could find on the internet. Forget ghouls and ghosts, this dude putting his underbelly on someone's head, that's your head, that's where you keep your dreams, that's so disgusting. It's not meant to be sullied by the girth of some man's stomach. I can only imagine the smell. It probably is a cross between Parmesan cheese and a burning orphanage. I would rather run into any of the supernatural or extraterrestrial creatures on this list than let this guy put his fast food gut on my head for 1 second. All right, everyone, that is our list. I hope you had a great time checking it out. As always, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Also, if you guys want more content, go check us out on Instagram and Facebook. Until next time, I've been Chade Arena, and you guys can take that clip from the beginning of the video of me and share it all over the internet. I was blackout drunk.